And you know, these frigid conditions, they have created hazards on our roads.
Minnesota State Patrol says there were more than 300 crashes Monday morning, more than 200 this morning. RJ Coles is live tonight with some helpful advice from MnDOT. Jay.
Jackie, so it was the light snow the last couple of nights that created a lot of the problems for the morning rush. But MnDOT tells me it's this right here. As the frigid air continues to pour in, this right here coming out of your exhaust pipe, that's not your friend on the road. It's a combo platter that no one really wants to see on the traffic menu.
There has been just crash after crash after crash.
And it's causing accidents and spinouts all across the metro. Light overnight snow that melts slightly and turns to ice, along with a lot of idling cars and trucks stuck in traffic jams, making fumes into hard to see ice and drivers navigating as best they can.
Luckily, my car is it's a stick shift. So oftentimes, instead of braking, what I typically do is one, I don't typically go the speed limit, but two, I also use that downshifting. So that really helps out quite a bit. Instead of hitting the brakes, slamming on the brakes.
Have you had any problems?
No, with my big truck, I have not had too many problems, but then I drive slower, I know better, so, yeah.
You've seen it enough to know.
Oh yeah, a lot of cars in the ditch, that's for sure.
And MnDOT says that's what everyone should be doing on the roads during this cold snap, and they say be aware of backups because those spots will give you a heads up as to potential ice.
A couple crash sites in the same area, because as that traffic slows down, again, you're having the exhaust drip and you're getting that extra friction as folks slow down for that particular crash. So then some more slick spots actually get created in that same spot as a result.
And MnDOT says salt and other materials take longer to work in the extreme temperatures, and so it's best to, quote, know before you go.
You can look at a site like 511mn.org, check out your route. Maybe you'll see, hey, there's a couple crashes there, or that's indicating that it's a little slicker than some other spots. So maybe you'll either change your time of travel or take a different route.
And as meteorologist Ren Clair is telling you, you might as well be ready for this. At least into early next week, you're going to be dealing with this. And the best way for you to need to know before you go, of course, is with Josie every morning on Channel 5 and Eyewitness News on 45. Reporting live in St. Paul, Jay Coles, 5 Eyewitness News.